In this episode, I'll show you how to replace a sign. I'm Mark Spencer from RippleTraining.com. Welcome to Motion Magic, where you'll learn visual effects and motion graphics in under 5 minutes. Here I am in Motion, where I've imported this video clip. I want to replace the top road sign. I've also imported the graphic that I made in Photoshop to replace the sign with. I'll move it over the current sign. To track it to the sign, I'll use the match move behavior. However, there are two tricks to making this work. I'll go to the library, to behaviors, to motion tracking, and drag the match move behavior onto the graphic. In the heads up display, I'll make sure the type is set to four corners, and then try moving the tracking points in the canvas. But since the points I want to track aren't at the corners of each sign, this approach won't work. I'll delete the match move behavior. The first trick is to align the graphic to the sign before applying the behavior. I'll press Command Plus a few times to zoom in, hold down the space bar and drag to center the sign, right click it and choose Distort. Then I'll align the graphic to the sign. With that accomplished, I'll now add the match move behavior and make sure it's set to four corners in the heads up display. Now here's the second trick. If I start moving the tracking points now, the graphic moves with them. I'll press Command Z to undo that. What I need to do is go to the inspector, to the behaviors tab, and change transform from attach to source to mimic source. Now I can locate good high contrast tracking targets like the corners of the letters without distorting the graphic. Once I position each one, I adjust it in the tracker preview in the inspector. Now I'm ready to click the Analyze button in the heads-up display. The white dots represent the path of the track. During the analysis, the graphic appears to move much more than it will when it's done. If I scrub through, the track starts off well, but it's quite off by the end. To clean up the track, I'll move the playhead back home, go to the Properties Inspector, and set keyframes for each of the four corner parameters. These gear icons indicate that a behavior is controlling these parameters, but in Motion, you can freely mix behaviors and keyframes. Then I'll go to the end of the project, select the graphic in the layers list, and realign it in the canvas. Then I'll go to the middle of the project and do the same. Then I'll check the alignment a quarter of the way through and three quarters of the way through, adjusting as needed. I'll press Shift Z to fit the clip back to the canvas, click below all the layers to deselect everything, and play the project. Click the subscribe button below. If you have an idea, comment, or suggestion, leave those below as well. Go to RippleTraining.com for fast professional training on Final Cut Pro, Motion, and DaVinci Resolve from industry professionals.